to the latest in the Jerry Sandusky trial. A Centre County jury is weighing the evidence and credibility of witnesses, deciding Sandusky's guilt or innocence. Andy Mahalshik joins us now live from the Centre County Courthouse in Bellefonte with the very latest. Andy.
Well, good afternoon. The prosecution team, members of that team, just walked into the front door of the Centre County Courthouse here in Bellefonte, Centre County. We don't know why they went in. I went to the courtroom a few moments ago. It appears they're in the chambers with the judge, and that normally means that there's some kind of a question or issue with the jury. Now, the jury began the deliberations at 1:12 this afternoon, so a little more than 4 hours and counting, and still no verdict. Now, the jury, the closing arguments were also given today by the prosecution and defense teams. Prosecutors say, and they told the jury, Sandusky is a serial child predator. But the defense team says he's a victim of a conspiracy.
Defense attorney Joe Amendola told the jury that Jerry Sandusky is a victim of a tainted police investigation. He insists that most of the accusers have a financial motive. He talked about the first allegations being made back in 1998. Charges were never filed in that case. He said, Jerry had contact with hundreds of thousands of kids since the 1970s. Not one complaint was filed by a child, a parent, or a teacher. Nobody. Are we to believe that a man in his 50s at the time suddenly wakes up and is a pedophile? Amendola argued that investigators went looking for victims, even leading most of them down the path to making more serious allegations. He says that when first contacted by police, most of the accusers said nothing happened or something minimal happened, then added allegations when led by police. He talked about Mrs. Sandusky, Dottie. Dottie Sandusky was always in that house. She never saw anything. Don't you think she would have walked in on something if all these bad things were going on? He reminded the jury of the testimony of a neighbor, of one of the alleged victims. The victim's mother allegedly told that neighbor she would have lots of money and own Sandusky's home because of the scandal. Attorney Tom Klein represents one of the alleged victims. He says talk of financial motive based on this trial is simply nonsense.
Any future case needs to rise and fall on its facts. What Penn State knew, when they knew it, who was responsible for allowing that. And each young man who ever brings a case against Penn State or against Second Mile needs to prove to that jury satisfaction.
And there are late-breaking developments in this case. We've just learned that Matt Sandusky, one of Jerry Sandusky's adopted children, has confirmed that he would have testified yesterday against his father. Again, Matt Sandusky, who has been in court with his father, he too was allegedly abused by Jerry Sandusky. Now, Jerry Sandusky, we were told, was supposed to testify yesterday. For some reason, he didn't. We're finding out now, according to Matt Sandusky's lawyers, had Jerry Sandusky testified, Matt Sandusky would have been called to testify against his own father. Again, late-breaking developments. His adopted son, Matt Sandusky, now claims he was abused sexually by his father, Jerry Sandusky. We'll be following the developments here all night long. Of course, break in when the verdict comes in. Reporting live in Bellefonte, Centre County at the Sandusky trial. Andy Mahalshik, back to you.
All right, we'll be talking to you. Thank you, Andy.